Hi, my name is Brian Green. I work for Water Quality Extension up at Utah State University, and we're here to talk about building your own rain barrel. Now, there are lots of options that you can go out and do. There are commercial options that you can buy, but an easy and cost-effective way is to build your own. We recommend using a food-grade 55-gallon plastic container. We prefer the ones that have the tops that you can open up, and this allows for you to be able to get in and clean it out and do any maintenance that you need to do. And the only thing that you really need to be aware about when you're using these is you want to have one that hasn't been storing any type of toxic or chemical things that might be bad for your garden or for the water that you're going to conserve in your rain barrel. So in this video, we're going to show you how to easy way to build your own and install one. So the tools that you'll need to be able to build your own rain barrel is you'll need a 1.5 inch by 3/4 inch threaded bushing. You'll need a 3/4 inch hose bib. You'll need a 1.75 inch hole saw to drill the hole that this will be able to go in. Then you'll need a 1 inch spade bit that you'll be able to use to make the connection point for the diverter. Then your tools, you'll just need a type of drill. We'll use some little silicone seal to seal up the edges. And sometimes it makes it a little bit easier if you have a heat gun or a hair dryer, you can even use at home, to warm up the plastic, makes the bushing a little bit easier to go in. And as always, when you're in doing any project, you wanna make sure you have your safety glasses and your gloves on. So now we're gonna show you the steps to go through to use these tools to build your own rain barrel. And then the first step is to insert, to cut a hole at the bottom, and this is going to be where your drain will be, where you'll be able to drain the water out when you need to use it. So the first thing you'll do is turn it over and put on your safety glasses and your gloves. And you'll have to select a place down at the bottom that you're going to want to make, insert, and drill the hole. So we now cut our hole. The next step is that we're going to need to insert the threaded bushing in there. Notice that when we cut the hole, we didn't cut it all the way down to the bottom. You want to leave a little bit of space in there because so it's right above the bottom, and it's on a flat part that'll make it easy for this bushing to fit in. What you will notice is that this is a pretty tight fit. We don't want this to be able to leak. And so one way that it can make it easier for this to screw in is to first heat up the plastic. If you have a really thick food grade plastic like this, it can be a little bit hard to just screw in by hand. And so if you heat this up with a heat gun, or you heat it up with a hair dryer, that makes it a lot easier to go in. So now after doing this for 1 to 2 minutes to just soften up the plastic, I'm gonna turn the heat off and be able to place this in through there.
Well, I mean, we'll just gently.
There we go. So now it's gone in there and it's made a nice clean seal with the barrel. Now the second step is to thread our 3/4 inch hose bib onto the bushing. Turn so it's tight and make sure that it's facing down. The third step is to help seal and waterproof the bushing on the bottom. Is we will take some silicone seal and just put this gel just right around the inside of the bushing to make sure that it doesn't leak. The last step is to drill the hole in the upper portion of the barrel for where we're going to connect the diverter to it. This hole needs to be on the side of the barrel that you want the downspout to be on. So for this example, we're going to do it on this side right here. We're going to take our drill with the 1-inch bit on it, and we're going to make a hole right on the side. We're going to put our safety glasses on. And we'll drill one right in here. So for the last step, now we're going to take the diverter connection and install it in the hole. And on the inside, we're going to screw in the backing so it stays nice and snug. So you just place it in there, tighten it down. So now we have our completed barrel. This is where the diverter, the rainwater, will come in. It'll also come out if it overflows. And then this is our outlet where we can take water when we need to use it for our garden or for our home. So this is an easy way to be able to build your own barrel, cheap, cost effective. And this is an example that we think works really well here in Utah.